Hello everybody! In this video lecture, you are going to learn about how to apply Ohm's law into series circuit. In a series circuit, there is only one path for the current to follow, from positive terminal back into negative terminal. There are no other routes or junctions for current to escape. For this reason, current through all circuit elements is the same. Therefore, total current is equal to current through first resistor and the second resistor. Voltage, on the other hand, can be different across each resistor. Just like a stronger pump is needed to push water through a narrow or more resistive pipe, higher voltage is needed to establish the same current through a higher resistance. So that higher resistance gets more, lower resistance gets less voltage. The sum of the two, however, has to be equal to the terminal or total voltage, as one battery is supplying the voltage. We can write the Ohm's law to solve the total current like this. Since the total voltage is equal to the sum of voltages 1 and 2, it can be seen that total resistance must also add up to keep the current the same. Therefore, total resistance in a series circuit is the sum of the individual resistors. This means every addition of a new series resistor will increase the total resistance and decrease the total current. Let's solve an example problem to test our understanding. A 12 ohm and an 8 ohm resistor are connected in series across a 6 volt battery. Find the equivalent resistance of the circuit, the current, and the potential drop across each resistor. Well, let's start by labeling our resistors. So here is the first one, R1, and here's the second one, R2. Now, what does it mean, the equivalent resistance? That's what I need to find. Well, equivalent resistance just means total resistance, and I know how to calculate total resistance on a series circuit. The total resistance is equal to sum of the individual resistors. So I have 12 plus 8 equals 20 ohm. That is the first step. Now, I also need to find the current and potential drop across each resistor. What is potential drop? Well, potential drop means the voltage used for that particular resistor. Okay, so let's start by calculating the total current. Let's apply the Ohm's law for the total values. I total is equal to V total over R total. So this would be equal to 6 volt divided by 20 ohms, and that would be 0.3 amp. So this is the current for the total circuit, but I know that since there is only one pathway to go, the individual current that passed through each resistor will still be the same. So I1 is the same as I2. That is the same as a total current of 0.3 amp. So here is the current. And finally, let's find the potential, which is the voltage. Now, I am going to apply the Ohm's law once again, but this time the Ohm's law is going to apply individual resistors. So V1 is equal to I1 times R1. So I know I1 is equal to 0.3. And R1 is equal to 12. So this is going to give me 3.6 volts. Well, I can do the same thing for the resistance number 2. So the voltage 2 is equal to I2 times R2. And that's going to be 0.3 times 8. And V2 happens to be 2.4 volts. Now, I knew that the total voltage is supplied by a single battery, therefore the sum of individual voltages should still be equal to 6 volts. Double checking, V total is 3.6 plus 2.4. Yes, it's still equal to 6 volts. This means my solution is correct. Well, that's all for today. Thank you for listening.